Hey guys, what's up? I'm Ashwins here. I just figured my list of replays has gotten considerably larger than last time, so I just figured I'd go ahead and just run through something real fast. I know the last one is pretty long, but I'm just going to go ahead and show these to you guys to showcase them on a channel, that way I can just delete them. So this one's a two-way victory. This, I believe, is because I won two different ways. The first reason I won is because of the fact that I was going to win due to the sheer amount of damage I was able to put out, but also because of the time limit. I'm not completely sure. He just goes for the Dragon Strand, and I nullify that with Dark Bride. He actually, the second I'm okay with that, he goes for Veil Band. Plus I banished Cyber Shadow with Sarcophagus, which turned one, so with that, I got out of Cyber End, died, and there's the error, and the fight ended. These are just kind of random ones, it doesn't really matter. This is the 50 LP Clutch God. This one is actually really special to me, so I'll be keeping that one no matter what. Here's just an amazing GOAT duel. Me and some of my friends were playing GOAT format. This one's based off a friend of mine, you can know this build. And then I have another deck that I made myself from scratch. So I'll probably be showcasing that in the deck profile a little bit later on. But this is just this is just really my first duel with GOAT, or at least on Wiser Pro. I've done some GOAT duels on other sites, Dueling Book, Dueling Network, back when that was up. But this is just my first duel. Alright, here, a cool combo you can do is you can use Snatch Steal to snatch up someone's monster and tribute it in order to use Ursa, Parsha. Also, you can use Super Yomi to consistently and continually flip up and down your flip monsters in order to get out as many combos as possible. Whether you want Pot of Freed, there's the Charity, just whatever card you want, it's in a good version of it. This is back when I'm using the Metamorphosis build. It definitely wasn't very good. Well, it's not that it wasn't a good build, it's just I didn't play it too well. Of course, I have Sinister Serpent and the Magician of Faith. And, yeah. There's that. There's the Scapegoat, since I'm something that's annoying, set to the pass. Also, in this build, my out to it is using the distraction. As you can see, we're both very close to death here, so it's just a matter of time. I use Sinister Serpent there to add it back in hand. This is the Pure Rabbit version, since there was no errata change back when GOAT 1 was things like that. I didn't take Spirit Reaper for the power-up, more so for the fact that it was spot removal, which back in GOAT 1 was pretty much the only spot removal that was in existence, because it was basically the precursor to Kaiju, just so it was that. We not only swapped tokens, but the exact same cheap token. That's what I thought was pretty funny. And of course, the best part about it to me is the fact that we are so close to life points. I use Metamorphosis on a token to get under 1,000 life. So just figure out that that's something you can actually do. Also, if you use 1,000 life restrict to steal a face down monster, it's just apparently, it just makes attack points to 0. I do like the interaction with that, where you just have, tons of cards either in your hand or on your field, and then they'll use a heavy storm and just the sound of it constantly stacking the card destruction sound effect is just awesome. This is me just beating Hazmat K multiple times. I'll just see if they'll load in real fast. For the sake of time, and when I say I wreck him, I mean, considering this guy's playing, I guess, Burn, is what I'm gonna call this. I mean, this looks like a chain burn. I don't know why he sets a duality instead of the Babaku. At first, I'm thinking he's playing chain burn with the secret blast kind of setup. So, that's why I'm going for the Jinzo play, but there's that. I draw into the Maxi, which is just such a good draw, honestly. And I give up Reaper for the Jinzo and just start attacking. He can't really activate or do anything to an extent. That was pretty much his only move. And of course, I draw into the Malefic Cybran, which is just like the top deck of the century. And to make it worse, I have Jinzo, and of course, the error occurs. And I don't know why the errors are always occurring, but they are. This is just him again. He just surrenders. There's another awesome comeback. It's a shame because the replays always just end. This is against, yet again, me and my friend Maho, who just plays Dynamis, DMs, stuff like that. And I'm playing Achilles of Frogs. I might make a deck of Clawback on that as well pretty soon. But yeah, I just decided to do that just to get the cards off the field. I'm trying to kind of keep up with what he's doing, but I don't know. Yeah, and I'm playing, Slimepaw Frogatune. Yeah, Slime Tid, my bad. I don't know why it's got a different name. One appears to be, I guess it's just because there's a monster's effect that, I remember, I think it's Ronin Totem that says that you can't use Frog to Jam, but it got switched to Slime Toad, so I guess I can use some target for that. I think that's probably the only Harada I know of that actually has Harada that changes just the name and the actual effect. Kind of like what they did with Dark, with Fallen Nurse Refuel, who's now Dark World Nurse Refuel, because, you know, that's just, you need to be searchable. Yeah, because you need to be more easily searched. That's what we need. Yeah. I've never actually seen 37 until then, so just in that past 5 and I have doubled my Kaya. Yeah, see, just except Frog and Jam from the graveyard. So, by those standards, since it's called Slime Toad in the English version, you should be able to use it, but, you know, whatever. Makes sense. Right now I'm just getting screwed. I really am. So I just draw into my cylinder, and I just set too fast. I have double frogs in my hand, which is like the worst possible hand to have. You know what, Dynamists, they're really hard to kill, or at least in the Pendulum Zones, because you have Dynamis Charge, and then they have the pack where you can bounce one back, negate it. They also negate the first spell trap after they're during the turn. It just gets really, really difficult. He shuffles back my slime to anything that can be hooked down up there. Just needs his turn, and I draw into a Billy Paleozoic Cardiac, so I get pretty lucky with Marowak. I do this, I go into Totally Awesome, I just attack, I get rid of that, and then I activate Totally Awesome's effect. Kaya, draw 2, set 1, pass, which is lucky because I just so happened to draw my Drowning when I really needed it the most. So I'll just shuffle everything back into the deck, and now chain Warmilla, how do you say its name? Makes it fusion into Panzer Dragon. And he's only summoned again. He goes from the Shadow Dragon Nova and Infinity.
Basic plays. Tries to target it, but
it's also a trap, as well as a monster type that doesn't work too well. Going to another one. My totally awesomes. I beat up the token pass. Now he's fast, he's away from draw frog. He's gonna go ahead and pendulum summon. Well, this right now I'm just getting my butt handed to me. Also a platter. He's gonna just negate this effect right here. I don't really know what was going on, to be honest. I was just like, okay. I was kind of playing the cards I did to them. Something I will say about this is it does look like the one that they're showing on. That software has. Well, at least to me it does. But I don't know, I guess it's up to the individual's interpretation of it. Getting that Kaya.
Treat for swap frog for group frog, something like that. I believe it's Venomous Charge. Rush, same thing like this. Twin Twisters to get that taken care of, and then there's that nice negated. And then set to my field, which is basically just clogging at this point. And then I make that thing. I double attack. And attack directly twice, and then I normally try things up, but I gave myself a small lead overlay to this thing because I can't go into Toad anymore since I'm out. I've already been at 3 copy max, so. With that, gate, and I pop, and gate. It's normally used as a spell or trap. But, if you just so happen to negate and pop a monster, you set it to finish the monster, and of course, I win, and there was an awesome comeback, so there's that. Nonsense, I guess, is a higher ranking player, I don't really know. I don't remember too much, but, as you can see, you can flip the fly out of here. It used to be, her name was Nurshrek Fuel, the following one, and now it's Dark Lord Nurshrek Fuel, meaning Dark Lord Contact Search it. For a Chainburn opponent, he shouldn't have gotten wrecked as hard as he did. But then again, the Shriver and James at 3. In GOAT format, I would have been so messed up. Then again, Chainburn didn't exist in GOAT format. But of course, I have the game seal. I just attack and turn pass. He uses Upstart. That's another thing. You can now use Banishment of the Dark Lord to get and search out your Wallinus Refugees now because of the name change that just screwed us all over. So there's that now. There's more power to the Chamberlain play. This is precisely what this game needed. I just attacked directly and I'm feeling pretty good about myself because it's 8k to 2500 against someone who is, I'd say, fairly high on the leaderboard. She's so good at talking, so this is where I start noticing things are missing. It should be said that I basically win. He just passes for turn because there's nothing to do. I basically just attack into this for game. I draw into another Jinzo, which is the top deck of the century. I tribute this tribute with quotation marks to negate all other trap cards, that way Dimension Wall doesn't kill. But then at the same time, Cyber Shadow attacks her game, because since it's trapped in a monster, it's already on the field, it's negated. So I just go in like that. This is just between a rock and a hard place. I don't remember in whose favor this was. Malefics, yeah.
This is just plain good. This is just... Keep in mind, I'm playing Go. Keep in mind, I'm over here being honorable playing Go, and this one's playing Dark World, you know. So, yeah. I really wish you could skip out of fights, but I just wanted to contribute. I eventually ended up taking this guy out because I just don't like him so much, to be honest. He's basically the GOAT Hornets version of Curry Bandit, which, basically is. What even is that? Oh, yeah. Okay. So it really is just. Okay. So it's. Yeah. Yeah, this is the God Card player, too. I was gonna say, like, what is that? The GOAT. And it's funny, because I always say GOAT format only, because I know people will come in here and try to do other stuff, but, no. That's why I put it, and I recently started putting GOAT format as a password, that way only my friends can get in. That way I don't just have random people playing Masterpiece against me, or, well, not ZDX, they're dead now, but, well, not entirely, but they're basically that sort. But there are just too many. Like, look at this. I mean, this is just ridiculous. Of course, there's 12 cards in his hand, so I think it's like 12 Jedi points, attack points. I mean, that thing is like 7.6 attack points. That boosts him up to 14k, and he just attacks for game. So, yeah, don't bring him after a gunfight. Well, it's a close game, destroying DM. Strong hazmat, dirty plays. GG, yeah, I remember this one. Yeah, this one I got, like, two Malefic Sirens, like, back to back, I believe. It wasn't nice. It was not nice. Oh yeah, because this one's being honorable playing 6-7s. I remember Captain 101 is up there, but this poor guy. This is back when I first started YGO Pro. You can tell because I was still running the gift card, Oprah Skate, 2-card combo to join to my Zodia pieces. With the float slash stall engine of Spear Reaper. And I'm not even running which the Black Forest in this build. I'll just quickly show you guys. This is before I even running that. I'm running Jinzo though. I'm running mostly noob cards. Oh no, no, I am. Okay. But this is before I took out the other cards. Took out the Quaking. This is still a relatively early version of the build. There's that. Basically, Captain 101 on the scene just relies on using one of the 6-lands to pop monsters that he can't get over himself. And that's just, it's both a good and that's just both a key card and a weakness at the same time. His deck, because when you're relying on one card, it's not usually a problem. But if it's something like this, where it's a level 3,
with 1600 attack and almost anything that had beats over it. I mean, it's just, it's a bad round. I try into that for Dark Vibe, so I just set that in turn. It gets duality, but it doesn't matter. And I just have to have a shadow. And yeah, he just switches to defense mode and just apparently we play keep ending, but yeah, that's basically the extent of it. These are just some goat duels. Okay, with battle shape. Most of these are just nothing really. What is this? Oh yeah, yeah, okay. This is a later version of the build. Oh, what is this? Torbus of the end of the world. What is that called? Garbage over? Mr. X. I've not seen that before. I've seen it before, I just don't see it played. That really looks like an injector card to me for a moment. Apparently the error that they just keep occurring. These journeys are just nothing, they're just my ranks. Ladders, basically. This is a very, very important duel, so I'm just not gonna believe that. This is this is when I get like triple copy of this is where I just end up with like three copies, all three copies of this is where I end up with three copies of it's just sorry, it's just the fact that this stuff can happen, it's just ridiculous. Maybe if I can finish my sentence without laughing, just practically have to kill myself. This is me getting triple totally awesome out in the field at once. I end up with, it's sad, it really is sad because I end up making triple tree code, and I believe even on the other abilities that with monsters. I really don't believe it was open. I believe it was this one, the Anoma Locus. But I just go into my second one there, and I end my turn. And spoiler alert, next time I make my third. I didn't know this at first, but he was actually playing, Exodia, apparently. I saw this and I was like, oh, this deck. I know all about the Hope for Escape strat. I'm Breck, the one who coined it. So here I make my third totally awesome. And I go in for another one. No, I do make the red one. Okay. Nice attack again. I mean, it's ridiculous, it really is. So, yeah, this is just, no, but this, it's out, I'll just save I'll save the rest of these funny ones for later. So, that being said, thank you guys so much for watching. I've been your host, Thomas Phoenix, signing off. See you guys next time. Have a good one.